One of the biggest problems facing humankind today is the energy problem. Finding sustainable and scalable ways to produce energy has been on the minds of many scientists lately because, with each passing day, it's become clear that fossil fuels are definitely not the way ahead. Renewable energy, on the other hand, just isn't powerful enough to charge up megacities and lead us towards our next phase of evolution. Scientists have been looking at this problem for decades, and they have a potential solution that could solve this problem. And that solution is fusion energy. If the mention of the word fusion summoned up images of a nuclear mushroom cloud going up, raining down fire and radiation on everyone, then you're not alone. The terms fusion and fission are linked with nuclear reactors. For decades, we've used fission reactions to power our nuclear reactors. Every functional nuclear reactor in the world today is a fission reactor, but the problem with fission reactors is that they produce a lot of radioactive waste. And if you remember the Japanese tsunami, you'll know that nuclear reactors are extremely dangerous. Any sort of damage can result in a potentially deadly scenario, leading to mass evacuations and decades of radioactive fallout. There's a reason why not many countries have switched to nuclear energy. Firstly, not a lot of countries have the technological capability. But apart from that, the dangers of having nuclear power plants everywhere are far too great than the benefits of clean electricity. Just remember that even after a decade of the Japanese tsunami, we still can't fathom the extent of damage done in Fukushima Prefecture. While fission reactors are dangerous and produce a lot of radioactive waste, fusion reactors, on the other hand, are a completely different story, which is why a concerted attempt is happening right now to build the world's largest nuclear fusion reactor in France. But before we start talking about this mammoth reactor that may possibly create a black hole on Earth, let's first end the whole confusion between fission and fusion for those of us who aren't nuclear scientists. What is fission? Fission reaction occurs when a nucleus is split into two or more smaller nuclei. Nuclear fission is used in most of the world's power plants and is the main source of nuclear energy today. It's a very efficient process of creating energy, as it requires a small amount of radioactive material to create a lot of energy. To get a fission reaction, you basically have to take two atoms and smash them together under the correct temperature and pressure conditions. Once the nucleus splits, an enormous amount of energy is released, which then triggers a chain reaction to keep the reaction going. The first fission bomb that was tested produced energy equal to 20,000 tons of TNT. Fun fact, the bombs that America dropped over Japan were actually fission bombs as well. When the same fission reaction is done inside a nuclear reactor, the heat energy produced by the reaction can be used to heat up water, to turn it into steam, to run the turbines and generate electricity. Strange that the same thing can be used to both destroy and create. Anyway, so this is how fission works. Now, the obvious drawback of fission is that it loses too much energy and creates a lot of radioactive waste. That's a headache to remove safely. This brings us to fusion power. What is fusion? A fusion reaction is simple enough to understand. You take two atoms and smash them together to create another atom. See how different it is from fission? In a fission reaction, we smash the nucleus to break it up. But in fusion, we try to smash two atoms under the right temperature and pressure conditions to create a heavier atom. We see and benefit from fusion reactions every day without even thinking about it. Yes, the sun is literally a fusion reactor. The sun has the right temperature and pressure to keep a perpetual fusion reaction going on till it exhausts its fuel. Fusion reactors don't produce any wastage or radioactive material, and in theory, they can solve our energy needs because the output of energy from fusion reactions is vastly more than a fission reaction. If you've been paying attention so far, you'll remember that earlier we said the first fission bomb that was tested produced energy equal to 20,000 tons of TNT. Well, the first fusion bomb that we tested produced energy equal to 10 million tons of TNT. Now, imagine if we could harness fusion power inside a reactor. Sounds easy, right? Tony Stark was able to make a reactor in a cave. How hard could it be? Well, as it turns out, very hard. There's a reason why our first choice was fission reactors. Fusion reactors need the temperature to be at least 150 million Celsius before the reaction can even begin. Do you know what else is 150 million Celsius hot? The core of the sun. So all we need to do is figure out how to create the core of the sun on planet Earth. Well, don't be surprised when we tell you that this is exactly what scientists at the International Thermonuclear Experimental Reactor in France are trying to do. ITER is funded and run by 7 member parties: the European Union, China, India, Japan, Russia, South Korea, and the United States. Construction of the ITER complex started in 2013, and assembly of the tokamak began in 2020. The budget of ITER is expected to exceed $60 billion, making it the most expensive venture ever taken by any group of countries in the entire history of humanity. If we succeed, then we will solve our energy problem and move towards the next phase of human evolution. And if we accidentally create a star that ends up killing everyone, turning the Earth into a massive fireball that eventually collides into the sun, creating a black hole, well, in that case, at least we tried. Right now, this supermassive fusion reactor is almost 78% complete, and it's expected to become operational in 2026. Now, the reason why a massive effort is being taken to create a ginormous fusion reactor is because small fusion reactors, sadly, don't work. They need vastly more input of energy to produce a very small amount of output, which makes them unfeasible. A number of attempts have been made in the past, such as in 2012, with the focus fusion technique that was used to heat plasma up to 1.8 billion Kelvin. The core of the sun is only 15 million Kelvin, but this technique was scrapped because it's not commercially viable. In 1997, the Joint European Torus, or JET, fusion reactor produced around 16 megawatts of energy by injecting 24 megawatts, so basically resulting in a net loss of energy. Most recently, China's experimental advanced superconducting Tomahawk set a new world record last week when its artificial sun achieved a plasma temperature of 120 million degrees Celsius for 101 seconds and 160 million degrees Celsius for 20 seconds. Remember that this is a record for time. The East reactor was only able to sustain the artificial sun for a maximum of 20 seconds. That's how long it takes some people to find their phone charger. So at present, fusion reactors are completely useless for commercial production, which is why scientists came up with the brilliant idea to make ITER as big as possible, because the bigger it is, the more power it'll produce. ITER will be the first fusion reactor built in the world that will be able to produce power on a reliable basis. Its main goal is to give the world a prototype that's capable of producing 500 megawatts of energy from a fusion reactor. ITER will comprise of multiple sections, and each section is going to be the biggest of its kind ever built for a nuclear reactor. The vacuum vessel is the central part of ITER. It's a double-walled steel container in which the plasma is trapped through magnetic fields. The vacuum vessel of ITER will be twice as large and 16 times as heavy as any previously manufactured fusion vessel. Each of the 9 torus-shaped sectors will weigh approximately 500 tons for a total weight of 5,000 tons. When all the shielding and port structures are included, this adds up to a total of 5,116 tons. ITER is based on magnetic confinement fusion that uses magnetic fields to contain the fusion fuel in plasma form. The magnet system used in the ITER will be the largest superconducting magnet system ever built. The system will use 4 types of magnets to achieve plasma confinement. 1. A central solenoid magnet. 2. Poloidal magnets. 3. Toroidal field coils. And 4. Correction coils. Another important thing worth noting is the fuel that will power ITER. Fission reactors use nuclear fuels, such as plutonium and uranium. As a result, fusion reactors don't need radioactive materials. ITER is going to be fueled by deuterium and tritium. Now, deuterium is abundant in nature, but tritium is very rare. There's only about 3.5 kilograms of tritium on Earth. This would make the cost of producing energy very high, which would render the fusion reactor useless for commercial purposes in the future. To work around this problem, the geniuses behind ITER decided to embed a breeder blanket next to the vacuum vessel. The breeder blanket is expected to produce tritium through the reaction of neutrons with the plasma. ITER will have a massive 3,850-ton stainless steel, helium-filled cryostat surrounding the vacuum vessel and the superconducting magnets. The purpose of this is to provide a super cool vacuum environment to prevent the heat from radiating out from the vacuum vessel and melting everything outside. This will make ITER the hottest and the coldest place on Earth at the same time, once the fusion reactor is activated. All of these massive components will be housed on a 180-hectare site inside a 7-story building. The components are pre-assembled in the assembly hall and then taken to the actual site of the reactor to be put together. There are also going to be numerous other buildings, such as cooling towers, electrical rooms, operations control rooms, and other related facilities situated around the main reactor building. Well, we hope that ITER becomes a success because if it doesn't turn into a planet-eating star, it will definitely turn into a $60 billion black hole. Various pressure groups have voiced their concerns at the vast amounts of funding being put into ITER, which is never going to be connected to the electric grid anyway. It's a massive test to see whether fusion energy can be created and sustained on Earth or not. So, even if it's a success, we're decades away from actually having our homes powered by fusion energy. By which time, Elon Musk will probably have settled on Mars and figured out some new way to generate electricity. So, what do you think? Is it worthwhile to inject billions of dollars just to see if we can harness the power of the sun? Do you think this money could have been better invested into other, more sustainable methods of creating energy? Or do you think that humans should push their limits? Let us know what you think in the comments section down below. And like always, if you enjoyed the video, make sure you subscribe to our channel and stay up to date with all of our latest releases. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.